Hello and welcome to my channel. It's time for my last Halloween tutorial of this year, so I decided to go all out and turn myself into some form of demon. Basically, this look is, well, you know, it's mostly the outfit that really gives it a specific theme, because his makeup actually is pretty versatile. Like, you know, it's basically a lot of black lines on your face. But also, for this look, you only need normal makeup. You don't need to buy special effects stuff, so that's also good. So, yeah, let's get on to it. Okay, we're gonna start off with foundation. I'm actually going to use a foundation that's my natural skin color in winter. I never use it because I look like five different kinds of dead when I wear it. But it's actually ideal for this look. I'm just spreading it out over my face with a dome brush because, you know, I want to make myself look pale and even in color, but I don't need a perfect flawless skin because that's not the point of this look. So in other words, you know, go for something nice, but don't waste buckets and buckets of your favorite foundation on this. And once you look sufficiently dead, you can add a powder. You don't really have to. If you have dry skin, you can easily skip this step. I have oily skin, so I am going to use powder, because otherwise I turn into a disco ball. And that's not the look I'm going for today. But anyway, you can just, you know, go for a cheap powder if you are using powder. I'm just using my Catrice one, because, again, looking perfectly flawless isn't the plan here. Oh, by the way, I say that like there's something wrong with this powder. There is not. This is actually one of my favorite powders. It's just that compact powders usually makes fine lines pop up a little bit more underneath my eyes than a loose powder. And also, this keeps me matte like a little bit less long than my Jeffree Star powder. But nevertheless, there's nothing wrong with this powder, just so you know. Now, it's actually a good thing, I'm just blending out my nose contour a little bit with my foundation brush, that I use a powder that's not too powdery. Because I just realized I wanted to use a cream contour. Yeah. And it is usually a bright idea to not actually apply powder beforehand, but I already did it anyway, so we're just gonna roll with it. But anyway, I'm just making quite a sharp contour everywhere. And I'm sort of going for like silent movie vibes, you know, like in the sense of it all needs to be there and not subtly so. Like it needs to be dark. Like basically with the camera quality from back in like the other 20s, the 20s of 100 years ago. In that camera quality, it should still be visible, basically those kind of vibes. And just blending where I need with my foundation brush. That's basically my eraser here. Now we're also going to apply the contour product in the crease. Because next up I'm actually going to do my eye look using a gel liner mostly. And you know, I want a messy smoky eye. But I don't want it to look like I just tossed a jar of gel liner at my face. If you get what I mean. So I do want it to be slightly blended. And I think the, you know, the contour product is just going to help with that, because there's already going to be a little bit of darkness there. Next up, this step. Basically, I'm just going to apply with a sort of soft eyeshadow brush a gel liner all over the eyelids. One advice I can give you, and this has not much to do with the gel liner itself, but more with removing it. You're going to have to scrub this off, so it does pay off in the end to make sure you have a lot of eye moisturizer, like eye contour cream on, just to protect your skin a little bit, because really, like, the gel liner itself is not going to do much to your eyes. Like, the gel liner itself isn't a problem. The thing is that when you're going to assumably take it off at some point in time, you may want to actually have, you know, moisturizer there, because it's not going to be easy and it's going to be rough on the eyes to remove this all, just so you know beforehand. But yeah, basically I'm just blending it upwards. I'm not worrying about my eyebrows yet. I don't even know if I'm gonna fill them in. Sort of just depends on how the eye look is going to turn out. And really, you can just go whatever direction you want at any point. So it's the easy thing of makeup. Then just applying, almost stabbing myself in the eye with a pencil. That's not what I wanted to do. Point is, I'm just applying some pencil, black pencil on my waterline. You could fill in your waterline with a gel liner, but me personally, I just find it easier to use a pencil instead. Next up, black eyeshadow. Longtime viewers recognize this one as the Kiko eyeshadow that I somehow broke and still don't know how I broke it. I didn't drop it, it just started looking like this for no reason. Anyway, I'm just using the same brush as I did just now and just I'm going to apply this eyeshadow over the gel liner basically to set it. You might as well use the same brush for it because that way you only will have to wash one brush afterwards. Now I decided to do fill in my brows and I'm just going to do that a pretty quick and easy way actually. I'm just going to make brush strokes, but I'm going to make my eyebrows a bit longer and a bit bushy, basically. Sort of werewolf brows, but without going for the werewolf vibes. I'm basically just applying the product and pulling it only upwards. Using a brow pomade, you could use a pencil or something if you want, just a pencil, like basically just use whatever you normally use for eyebrows. I'm also not adjusting the color of them because I'm not going to wear a wig, I'm just going to keep my own hair color for this look. So my eyebrows are just allowed to match with it. But on the outer corner of the brows I am going to I'm tripping over my words. Going to go a bit more overboard with it because I really want that evil hairy brow. So I just want the outer part of my eyebrows to be a bit more out there, a bit more dramatic, I suppose. Just to really sell the whole idea of evil. Like so. I'm just going back to the contour stick. This is just a random decision. But I'm basically just making a little reverse C-shape on this side, normal C-shape on the other side. Blending it into the eyeshadow so no one sees where it begins or ends. And then I'm just going to blend it inwards very carefully. Because I want to look like I'm angry. I want to look like I'm frowning. But I don't want to frown the entire time. Because I don't want to give myself wrinkles and or a headache. So doing this with makeup is just a bit more gentle to yourself. But yeah, just keep building it up until you look sufficiently sufficiently angry, basically. Okay, truth be told, I actually originally planned on using a red lipstick to match the eyes, but now I just randomly decided I actually do want black on my lips, so I'm just going to use a gel liner and smudge it on there instead. And I do want a hint of red in it, so I'm just dabbing it in the middle. Now I'm just applying mascara. Also, by the way, about my mouth, you can probably tell I particularly made my lips turn downwards. Again, just in order to make myself look pissed off without actually having to, you know, use my face muscles for that purpose. Life can be so much easier with makeup. Now I'm gonna switch to a liquid liner in order to make some black veins on my face. And with that eyeliner we're going to do this. I actually would normally probably prefer to do this with a black body paint and then water it down a lot. But, you know, you can also do it this way. Just apply the liner, smudge it out with your fingers. And I thought it'd just be fun to, you know, for my final Halloween tutorial to actually do something That you can also do if you don't actually own any special effects makeup. And personally I feel like this kind of pencil liner is the easiest for this purpose. Although I do recommend to use a cheap one. This one, like I said, did I say that? Either way, it is by NYX, so it's good, but it's, well, it's actually one of my favorite liners, but it's not expensive. I don't actually own a more expensive eyeliner, but if I would, for example, own one by Urban Decay, I wouldn't use it for this purpose. Because you are using quite a lot of product for random stripes on your face, which I wouldn't want to do with a very expensive eyeliner, because I'm too much of a cheapskate to want to waste eyeliner on random stripes on my face. But yeah, anyway, the key to doing this is to just, you know, talk to a camera, or at least make sure you're sufficiently distracted in some way, shape, or form. So you don't pay too much attention to where you're putting this, because you just want this to look random. You don't want this to look like there's like a lot of reasoning behind where you put everything. It just needs to exist. Okay, at this point I think we're there in terms of makeup. Now for the rest of the look, to really like sell this entire thing as a theme. Like this actually in itself, like just put a black cape on and you already look sufficiently creepy without much effort. But I'm going to, oops, I just dropped a fang. Either way, I'm going to add some fangs. You can add whatever fangs you want. Do add ones that are safe to use, obviously. But you could just buy cheap ones off eBay. I have these ones, these were 15 euros at a local gothic store, they actually pop in. But trust me, whether you buy expensive or cheap ones, you probably won't be able to talk normally anyway, so it doesn't matter much as far as that's concerned. I used to be an intern at a goat farm. That's where I got these and I put them on a metal frame like years and years ago. So I can wear these. You could also buy decorative ones. Actually, I do recommend you buy decorative ones. Because they're probably a lot lighter, these are heavy as heck and they're going to hurt. So yeah, but just use, you know, just buy some form of like foam horns and just, you know, strap them to your head with like a hair tie, headband, this is a headband, not a hair tie. And just, you know, make some fun sort of costume with a scarf and we're all set. And here we have the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see a list of all the products I use, you can always find it below in the video description. If you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my YouTube channel. And for now, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!